Hello, I welcome you all in this course on steam and gas power systems. Today we will solve some of the problems on steam turbines, and that will conclude our discussions on steam turbine. The first problem is, the following particulars refer to a stage of an impulse reaction turbine. This is about the impulse reaction turbine. Outlet angle of fixed blades is 20 degrees. So, we will simultaneously start drawing the velocity diagram also. This is V1, this is VR1, this is peripheral velocity U, this is VR2, this is V2, and angles, this is beta 2, this is beta 1, blade outlet angle, blade inlet angle, nozzle inlet angle and nozzle outlet angle, right. And so, outlet angle of fixed blades is 20 degrees. So, outlet angle of fixed blades means fixed blades of previous stage. So, that becomes alpha 1, nozzle inlet angle. So, alpha 1 is 20 degree. Then outlet angle of moving blades, now the outlet angle of moving blades is beta 2. Beta 1 is inlet blade angle. So, beta 2 is 30 degree. Radial height of fixed and moving blades. So, radial height of the blade L is 10 centimeters or 0.1 meter. Mean blade velocity U is 140 meters per second. Speed ratio is U, rho, U by V1 is equal to 0.625. So, specific volume at moving blade inlet is, so VS1 is 1.24 meter cube per kg, and specific volume steam at moving blade outlet. So, VS2 is 1.30 meter cube per kg. Now, calculate the degree of reaction. It is not a Paasen turbine, right. So, we have to calculate the degree of reaction, adiabatic heat drop in pair of blades, total heat drop, the heat drop in the nozzle and heat drop in the blade, sum of that. Gross stage efficiency, coefficients, efficiency of the nozzle is 0.9 or 90%, and carryover coefficient is 0.85, and they are same in fixed and moving blade. Okay. So, first of all, since velocity is given, so we can find the peripheral velocity is given, we can find the inlet velocity. Inlet velocity is U, that is going to be 140 by 0.625, 224 meters per second. So, this V1 is equal to 224 meters per second. So, the steam is coming at this alpha 20 degree centigrade, it is 20 degree centigrade, and U is also with us, that is 140 meters per second. So, now we can easily draw the inlet triangle, because this base is known, this alpha is, this angle is known, this vector is known, 224 meters per second, and we can draw the triangle. Analytically also we can find the value of beta 1 or VR 1 or VF 1, whatever value is required. Now, after this, we'll use the continuity equation. Continuity equation say that area pi d l n v1 sin alpha 1. What does it mean? It means that velocity of flow, v1 sin alpha is velocity of flow, multiplied by area pi d ln, the blade passage, area of blade passage. So, this is the height of the blade and this is, we have taken periphery, entire periphery, it can have number of blades. So, multiplied by the height of the blade, this will give the area, velocity of flow will give mv1. This is a simple continuity equation which is used in the fluid mechanics. Now, again pi d ln vr2 sin beta 2, that is vr2 sin beta 2 will give us the mv2. Now, pi d ln, again this is the area multiplied by the velocity of flow at the outlet. So, velocity of flow, flow velocity multiplied by the passage area, flow velocity multiplied by the passage area, right. Now here why we have taken this? We have taken this, if you take the ratio of this, we have value of V1 and V2 as well, right. This will be cancelled out if you take the ratio of these two. Now, if you take the ratio, then pi will be cancelled out, d will be cancelled out, ln will be cancelled out, m will be cancelled out, v1 and v2 are already with us, right. So, we need not calculate them, v1 is with us, v1 is with us, and sin alpha is with us, sin beta 2 with us, because vf can also be v2 sin alpha 2. Or VR1 sin beta 1, we do not have these values. So, we have taken only those vectors for which we have the values, but we do not have the value of VR2. This value is not with us, right. So, in order to find this, so we have to find the value of VR2, and since all the other values are known, by putting these values, we will getting the value of VR2 as 160.6 meters per second. Now, we have the value of VR2 also with us, ok. Now, we have to calculate isentropic heat drop in blades. For calculating isentropic heat drops in the blades, we need VR2 square minus 5 VR1 square divided by 2 efficiency of the blades into 1000. This is the formula. Efficiency of the blades is also efficiency of the nozzles, we can take 0.9. VR2 is here 160, but we do not have the value of VR1. But since we have the other values in this triangle, we can always find the value of VR1. VR1 square is equal to V1 square plus U square minus 2uv1 cos alpha 1, v1 is 224 square plus 140 square minus 2 into 140 into 224 cos 20, and this finally gives the value of VR1 as 104 meters per second. From here, we will get the VR1 square, then we will take under root of VR1, we will be getting 104 meters per second as VR1. Once we have the value of VR1 with us, now phi is also given, phi is 0.85. We can find VR2 is 160.6 square minus 0.75 into 104 square divided by 2 into 0.9 into 1000. Sorry, this is 85, right. And this will give the enthalpy drop in the blades as 9.22. So, enthalpy drop in the blade is 9.22 kilojoules per kg. Right. Now, we have to calculate the enthalpy drop in the nozzles as well. And in order to calculate the enthalpy drop in the nozzles, we need the value of absolute velocity 2. Absolute velocity 1 is known, but we need to have the absolute velocity 2, V2. And V2 square, again, we will find V2 square is equal to VR2 square plus U square minus 2 U VR2 cos beta 2. Geometrically also it can be done, but if you do it numerically, we will be getting better or accurate value. Now, VR2 is 160.6 plus square plus 140 square minus 2 into 140 into 160.6 cos 30, right? And this will give the final value of V2 as 80.3 meters per second. So, V2 is 80.3 meters per second, right? And now, if I want to find, or if I wish to find the enthalpy drop in the nozzles, because that will give the total stage enthalpy drop in blades and enthalpy drop in the nozzles. So, enthalpy drop in the nozzles is going to be equal to V1 square minus phi V2 square by 2 nozzle efficiency into 1000 in order to convert it into the kilojoules. And that is V1 is 224 meters per meter per second minus 0.85 multiplied by 80.3 square divided by 2. Efficiency of the nozzle is 0.9 multiplied by 1000, and this will give the enthalpy drop in the nozzle is 24.83 kilojoules per kg. It means delta H n is equal to 24.83 kilojoules per kg. Now, in order to find the degree of reaction. Now, we have the values of enthalpy drop in nozzles, enthalpy drop in blades. So, degree of reaction is delta H blades divided by delta H nozzles plus, this is isentropic, the ideal case, and delta H B. So, it is going to be 9.22 divided by 9.22 plus 24.83, and this degree of reaction is going to be 0.271 or 27.1%. This is the degree of reaction of this particular stage. Now, adiabatic heat drop in pair of blades rings gross stage efficiency. Now, we have to find gross stage efficiency. In order to find gross stage efficiency, we should know the output of the turbine, VWU. So, VW, wind velocity is going to be equal to, we know the value of alpha 1 blade inlet angle, nozzle inlet angle and blade outlet angle. So, we will take V1 cos alpha 1 minus U plus VR2 cos beta 2, and then we will multiply this by U, that will give the output multiplied by U, right. So, V1 is 224 cos 20 minus 140 plus VR2 160.6 cos 30, this is multiplied by right here 140, okay. And this will be 140 multiplied by 205.8. divided by enthalpy drop in the stage, the divided by 1000, because it is in enthalpy drop is in kilojoules. So 9.22 plus 24.83. So when these are added, it is 34.05, and this ratio is 0.846 or 84. Similarly, we'll try to solve another numerical. This is about the Parsons turbine. So in Parsons turbines, we always know that degree of reaction is half, 0.5, and a Parsons turbine develops 1000 kilowatt power at 400 rpm and consumes 9 kg of steam per kilowatt hour. So per unit of power generation, or 1 kilowatt power generation, it consumes 9 kg of steam. Steam is supplied at 1200 kilopascal pressure and 250 degree centigrade temperature. So this is the pressure, it is 1200 kilopascal or 12 bar pressure, and temperature is 250, so it appears that it is a superheated steam. Isentropic efficiency of expansion is 85%. The blade angles are 35 degree and 20 degree at inlet and outlet tips respectively. So, blade inlet and outlet angle are given. Find drum diameter or diameter of the shaft and blade height at a stage where pressure is 150 kilopascal. The blade height to drum diameter ratio is 1:12. The ratio of 1:12 is recommended. So, the ratio of blade height and the drum diameter is 1:12. Find the power developed at the stage if flow velocity is 80% of peripheral velocity. Neglect the friction losses, right. So, here first of all, we will draw the temperature entropy diagram, because it is required here for a Rankine cycle, because the steam turbines, they work on Rankine cycle. So, try to understand this numerical, because steam is entering the turbine at 12 bar. So, steam entering here is 1200 kilopascal. It appears to be a superheated steam. It is superheated steam. And stage we are analyzing when the pressure is reduced to 150 kilopascal. So, when the pressure is reduced to 150 kilopascal, that stage we are analyzing. So, first of all, we must know the state of the steam at this stage, right. So, H1, 1200 kilopascal, saturation temperature is 187.96. So, at 250, the enthalpy is 2935.6. This is the enthalpy of steam, right. S1, if you remember what we have done during the analysis of vapor cycle and the entropy of this steam, 6.83 kilojoules per kg. Now, it is expanded to 150 kilopascal. So, 150 kilopascal saturation properties are here, and steam is definitely at this pressure, because 150 kilopascal is very low pressure. So, steam is definitely, it is somewhere here, right. So, steam is a mixture of liquid and vapor, and entropy here is of saturated vapor is 7.223. It means it is a wet steam. So, entropy is remaining constant. And S2 is equal to SF 1.4337 plus X SFG, that is 5 point multiplied by 5.78 893 and S1 is equal to S2. And from here we will get the value of x. So, value of x is from here it is coming at 0.932. That is the quality of steam at this stage when the pressure is 150 kilopascal. Now, at this stage we will calculate enthalpy H2, and H2 is again HF. HF is 467.13 plus 0.932 multiplied by latent heat 2225.97, and this gives the enthalpy at state 2. This is state 2. Now, this is not a state 2, this is a 2 dash. This is state 2, let us say this is state 2, right. So, enthalpy at state 2 as 2541.7, right. And H1 minus H2. Now, why we are doing this? We are doing this because once we know the H1 minus H2 and then delta H is equal to H1 minus H2, that is 2935.6 minus H2 is how much kilojoules per kg? 2541.7 kilojoules per kg. So, H2 minus H1 is delta H is 393.9 kilojoules per kg. Okay. Now, specific volume also we can calculate here. Specific volume V2 is equal to X. V2 is quality multiplied by specific volume, that is 1.1593, and that is going to be equal to 1.08 meter cube per kg. Now, mass flow rate. Now, if you look at the statement of the problem, 9 kg of steam per kilowatt hour, it means mass flow rate is 9 kg of steam multiplied by kilowatt, this is 1000 divided by hour, and this gives the mass flow rate as 2.5 kg per second. Right. Now, we will use the continuity equation again, pi dr plus height of the blade into height of the blade multiplied by Vf is equal to Mv. Same equation we used earlier, also continuity equation. So, it is pi dr plus dr by 12. Dr by 12 Vf is equal to Mv, and u, peripheral velocity u, is equal to pi dr plus dr plus by 12 n by 60 pi dn, and n is given here 400 rpm, and that is going to be equal to, find the power density if flow velocity is 80% of the peripheral velocity. It means this is equal to Vf by 0.8. 80% of peripheral velocity is Vf. So, this is equal to Vf by 8.8. So, value of Vf we can put here, from here, right, and the equation becomes pi dr plus dr by 12 dr by 12 into 0.8 pi dr plus dr by 12 n by 60 is equal to Mv. m we are having with us. Specific volume is also with us. So, this value is with us. So, we have mass, specific volume, mass is given here, specific volume we have already calculated, n is with us, right, and dr is not with us. Height of the blade is ratio is given, so we do not require height of the blade. Only unknown here is dr, right. So, we can write and we can solve this and we will get the value of dr as 0.772. Simply what we have to do, we simply, it will come dr cube is equal to something, 1 dr will come from here, 1 dr is here, 1 dr is here. So, dr cube multiplied by some value is product of mass and velocity, specific volume, and then again we will take the cubic root and we will find the value of dr. So, dr is 0.772 meters, this is a drum diameter. When drum diameter is with us, we can always find height of the blades. Height of the blade is drum diameter by 12. So, height of the blade is dr by 12, and once dr is with us, L can be calculated, it is coming as 6.4 centimeter, 6.4 centimeter, this is height of the blades. And u, now u is equal to pi dr plus dr by 12, once we have the value of dr, n by 60, n we are already having. So, we can calculate the value of u also, and that calculated value of u is 17.52 meters per second, right. Now, velocity of flow, once we have the value of u, then velocity of flow is 0.8 into 17.52, and this gives the velocity of flow as 40 meters per second. This is the velocity of flow, and now we have to calculate, because we have to find the power developed at this stage. So, for calculating the power developed, we need to have the value of Vw, vir velocity. So, we will draw a triangle. This is u, V1, VR1, VR2, V2. Now, here blade angles are known, 35 and 20, 35 and 20 degree. We know only beta 1 is, beta 1 is 35 degree and beta 2 is 20 degree, and we have the value of Vf. So, if we properly draw this diagram, actually Vf1 is equal to Vf2, there is no carryover. So, Vf1, so these they are equal, Vf1 and this is Vf2. So, this is component Vf1 and Vf2, Vf2. Both are equal, right. And so, now if we have to calculate the value of Vw, Vw will be, this is Vr1, this length plus this length, this is x, this is x and this is y, right, and this is the total will component. So, Vw is x plus y, and x is equal to, this is Vf1, Vf, so Vf is constant. So, Vf divided by tan beta 1 plus Vf divided by tan beta 2, right, is equal to Vf, we are already with having with us 14 by tan 35 plus 14 by tan 20, right. And this will give the value of Vw as 58.5 meters per second. Now, this value of Vw will be multiplied by 14, that is peripheral velocity, and in order to find the power developed is MVWU by 1000, that is the power developed in kilowatts. Mass flow rate we are having 2.5 kgs per second, VW is 58.5, U is 17.52 divided by 1000, and that will give the power developed as 2.56 kilowatt in this stage, right. That is all for today. From the next class, we will start with the gas turbines. Thank you very much.